We often examine episodes of terror and oppression in African American history, but what can we learn when we explore slavery, Reconstruction, Jim Crow segregation, and the modern day policies of welfare and mass incarceration for their impact on Black love and marriage? Among the systemic impediments to enduring Black relationships are three unmistakable culprits: inherited poverty and wealthlessness, the idealization of the patriarchal nuclear family, and Eurocentric standards of beauty. These obstacles, in fact, explain the astonishingly low marriage rates among Black women from all walks of life in America today. More than 70% of Black women are unmarried, and for the millions who prefer to be coupled, especially with Black men, their single status is not a reflection of personal failure. Forbidden Black love is America's unrecognized civil rights issue. America's founding fathers had the wisdom to envision both material and immaterial benefits of citizenship, but American society was constructed to deny one of the most important facets of these tenets to millions of Black women: the pursuit of happiness through love and marriage. And putting this problem into perspective allows us to see just how entangled Black romantic relationships are with racial politics in America, and just how much Black love matters to the health and future of our nation.
You're listening to or watching A Word from the Lord TV. My name is Pastor Michael Eaton. I'm your host for today's program, as well as I serve as the senior pastor of the Bethlehem Baptist Church right here in the heart of Paul's Valley, Oklahoma, USA. I'm also co-founder, along with my lovely wife, Kimberly Eaton, of A Word from the Lord, Inc., where she serves as president. And I'm so happy and elated that you have joined us on the Now Television Network. We're heard right after Rodney Howard Brown, Kenneth Copeland, and Joyce Myers at 5:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, there in New York, East Coast. And we're also heard on satellite television, on the Now Television Network, and 180 million households there in Europe. We're heard at 10:30 there in London, 10:30 in Paris, Parlez-vous Francais, that's all I know. 10:30 there in Africa, and also Logos, and also 10:30 there in the Middle East and Jerusalem. So we are so excited and delighted that you have joined us via satellite. You also can see us on these cable channels here in America on the screen. And we want to welcome you from whatever or however you're watching us today. It could be social media as well, on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, but we are so elated to be a part of your lives today. And I'm coming today and I'm sharing a message today, How to Become a Good Thing. It's a new series, Proverbs 18:22. It's really based on a book that I wrote entitled How to Become a Good Thing, A Christian Woman's Guide to Becoming and Choosing the Love of Her Life. Again, I wrote this book, and this series is what we're starting today, How to Become a Good Thing. You can pick up the book at AWFTL with Dr. Michael Kimberly Eaton.org. AWF stands for TL, stands for Word from the Lord, with Dr. Michael Kimberly Eaton.org. So please pick this book up and follow along in the series. And we're praying that God would use it to transform some lives in Jesus' name. Another resource that I am offering today is Black Love Matters in the Bible. It's in hardback only, or Kindle right now. It hasn't come out in paper books. It's my latest book, again, entitled Black Love Matters in the Bible, How to Apply God's Biblical Principles to Save Black Relationships and Families. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about that today, as God has put it on my heart to save the Black family, because 70% of our households don't have a man of marriage or a committed relationship in it. And because of that, there are all kinds of things that are happening in our communities that are detrimental because of the lack of family. And I've been challenging us to start that hashtag Black Love Matters movement. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that a little later as well. Also, we want to let you know of these authors who support our ministries. Reverend Chad Gray now, from 40 to 40. Personal testimony of how God delivered him from a 40-year bid. And he supports our ministry with his resources. Also, Charles Lindsay, some things I've learned, to which he tries to inspire the dreamers of the future with the wealth of experience that he has gained in his life. Some things I've learned. Cappuccino Adams, Life's Missing Link. If only I knew then what I know now, life would be different. I want you to pick up these books at Amazon.com, and all of the resources that I mentioned today can be found there as well. So please support these men as they support us to continue on the Now Television Network. In Jesus' name. Again, I told you I'm starting a new series today based on a book I wrote entitled How to Become a Good Thing. And it is a Christian woman's guide to becoming and choosing the love of her life. And this series is being preached to teach Christian women how to prepare for marriage. You prepare for everything else. Let me say it again. You prepare for everything else. If you're part of the Divine Nine, you had to prepare for that. If you have a degree, you had to prepare for that. If you drive a car, you had to prepare for that. In the career that you've decided, regardless of what you studied in college, you still have to go through a training process. You had to prepare for that. Everything in this life we prepare for, except it seems, is love, relationships, or families. There are people who are literally ignoramuses, and I'm not getting on you. I've learned my lessons the hard way. I'm talking about and to myself. I wrote another book, How to Choose a Worthy Mate and Find True Love. I'm talking about me. I'm not talking about you, but you can learn from my experience. Because I've learned some things too. Hello, Charles Lindsay. And I have some missing links too. Hello, Cappuccino Adams. But we can be ignoramuses when it comes to love and marriage. And we can make all kind of bad choices because of that. And we're in a time where Black relationships have been destroyed. And I am praying that God would use me like Dr. Martin Luther King and civil rights, that God would use me to save the Black family. If I should go down in history, I want to go down in history for saving the Black family. You've got to study what I'm teaching. Some of you need to go back to Black Love Matters in the Bible. Some of you need to go back to Sex and the Single Life. They were all books, but sermon series you can get on our website, AWFTL with Dr. Michael Kimberly Eaton.org. Go down to the YouTube tab and get it and watch it there. All these resources. I'm not new to this. I'm true to this. And I'm praying that God would use this to save the Black family and really all families, because 50% of Anglo-Saxons households don't have a man, a marriage, or a committed relationship in it. And our culture is devastated because of it. Black love, hashtag Black love matters. Black family matters. So this is the reason I'm preaching the series to prepare, to teach Christian women how to prepare for marriage in Jesus' name. If you followed along in the Sex and the Single Life series that I preached from my book and workbook, Sex and the Single Life, I talked to you about a woman that I said that is spot on with today's society and today's modern women in Ezekiel chapter 23. And I told you as I preached this before that that text I've never heard anybody preach from, but it's so relevant today. It was a message, a program entitled Sex and Depravity. And in that message, I talked about two sisters, Aholibah and Aholah. There were two sisters that God uses explicit sexual terms to describe these two sisters who represent two immoral places. They were illustrations of Samaria and Jerusalem. And God called these two places by those names I just mentioned, Aholibah and Aholah. And then in the text, God begins to use what we call today thought language for these two sisters. See, because they lusted after well-dressed and well-endowed foreign men, which was a metaphor for going after foreign gods. And in modern day terms, I told you I would have had to cuss to give you the true meaning of the text. And this text could best be described as celestial slut shaming. But I told you in that message and in my book that this is a perfect example of the modern black woman today. Aholibah, and really the modern woman today. She's thottish. And she's the one who's wants her rights. You know, she don't want you to slut shame her. She's protesting for her rights to be sluttish, to dress the way she want to dress. No kind of modesty. To be on Facebook, slutting herself out. And the sad thing about it is now that was a time in our culture and society that women who only had one kind of choice or no choices were doing that. In our day and time, you got educated women who have degrees, master level degrees, who are slutting themselves out on Instagram, on Twitter, who act like modern day porn stars. Hello, somebody. And they're putting themselves out that way, and they wonder why men don't want to choose them as mates. And we're going to talk about in the book a woman's face, figure, and her feminine appearance. And women who have a lot more going for themselves are thotting themselves on fans only. They wonder why men don't want to commit to them. They're putting themselves out as if they are a whole of it. They got a scripture text on their Instagram or Twitter. They say they love God, but they're thotting themselves out even though they're not thoughts. Whoo, that's deep, that's deep, that's deep. But a man will treat you the way you present yourselves in public. And we're going to talk about that during this series. Because we've got to train our women and our men who and what to seek for in true relationships. And we got to train our women how to not thought themselves out in Jesus' name. Now, in this book, we're going to talk about a woman's faith, a woman's feelings, a woman's fella. What is the kind of guy that you should go up? Again, I tell you, we're all ignorant a lot of times when it comes to relationships. Ignorant. We've studied nothing. There are people who have doctorate degrees who studied nothing about relationships and chose someone who was not proper for them because they did no study. They did no self-examination. We're going to talk about that today in today's program. Her feeling, her fella, her femininity. A lot being said that women don't operate in their feminine energy. And some women say, well, if I get a man in masculine energy, I will operate in my feminine energy. And that's a lie from the pit of hell. Because if you're not operating in your feminine energy, you're going to come to the relationship just like a man. And if it's a strong man, see, strong men don't deal with women that's not FEMA. They can't because you butt head too much. So you got to be who God created you to be. A woman's face, figure, and fashion choices for the gram. How do you dress? Are you thotting yourself out for likes? Are you thotting yourself out for hearts? Is that how you get your value? Don't you know you're more valuable than a like from somebody you don't even know? Views and people you don't even know. I know some of you trying to make money, but all money ain't good money. How are you presenting yourselves in public, and how is it affecting you in regards to getting a man? And this can affect that, your femininity, the way you present yourselves in public. Then we're going to talk about a woman's mental fitness, because everybody is not emotionally or mentally prepared to be married. We're going to talk about that. And a woman's friendships. Do you have friends that help to lead you and guide you in the way you should go? Or do you have women that drags you into that masculine energy as opposed to feminine energy? Are you taking advice, love advice, from other women who not been in long-term relationships? See, your friendships could be a good point of view on your future. Hello, somebody. You want to be married? Why are you hanging around all these single folk? Woo! That's another thing. So I want you to get this book. You need to get this book. It will metamorphosize your life. How to become a good thing. Because again, we've studied everything else. We studied how to drive, get into a car. We studied for our disciplines. We studied 12 plus or more to become a doctor, a medical doctor, but ignorant about relationships. A psychotherapist, I'm using the illustration of that today, but ignorant about our own personal choices and relationships. God wants to transform some lives today. And if that's going to happen, we've got to put a priority on Black love and Black families. Because if you don't know what's going on in our culture, you are part of the devastating effects that are happening in our culture. Young people are not marrying anymore. Men are not pursuing women anymore. It has changed. It has changed. And God has sent me here today to try to change the order of things in our community. Again, I want to be known. If I go down in history, I don't necessarily have to go down in history. But if I do, I want to be known as, number one, a Bible teacher, because that's all I preach from, is teach from. Everything I share about is from the Bible. And sometimes we hit points in the Bible that is so relevant in our culture that I have to press my weight on it. And family, Black family, I have to press my weight. Black love, I have to press my weight on it, because our community has been devastated. So if I'm known in history, I want to be known that God used me to save the Black family. In Jesus' name. We're talking about again today how to become a good thing, how to become a good thing. And this is the introduction from the book. And listen, we're looking at Proverbs 18 and 22, how, or he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. Let me say that again. He who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. I read to you Proverbs 18 and 22. May God only bless the doers of this marvelous and holy word. This message today is for men. And we're trying to get men in their masculine energy, and we're trying to get women in their feminine energy, because that's the only way a love relationship can work. Because if I said, in my own personal relationship, if my wife come to me like a man, she gonna get the response of a man. If she come to me in a feminine energy, She could probably get anything. But I have to be in my masculine energy first. Hello, somebody. And we're going to talk about three things. The Holy Spirit gives utterance. We're going to talk about the masculine summons, a masculine search, and what will happen when God gives you favor. Something stupendous will happen when God gives you favor in your masculine energy. I want Christian men to know today that Christian men, they should search for the wife God has made for them so that they can be blessed. We want women to allow God to remake you over into the image that God has created you to be so he can put you with a masculine man who loves the Lord in Jesus' name. I've been trying to start along with that hashtag Black Love Waits movement or Black Love Matters movement, the hashtag Love Black Love Waits, because we have to stop all this sexual immorality that's going on in our culture, in our society, and in our churches, sadly, as well, and in our pulpits, sadly, as well. But for you Christian singles, I want you to pick up this, and like I tell you throughout the programs, at solidrockjewelry.com, I'm not getting anything from this, but I want you to make this commitment that I will wait for my beloved, for this is the will of God. I want you to pick that up. I want you to wear that ring. I want you to post about it. I want you to tweet about it. I want you to start a movement, because if we're going to save the Black family, we got to stop all this sexual immorality, because statistics say, and I share in my book, Black Love Matters in the Bible, the more sexual partners you have before marriage, the less likely your marriage is going to work, because you're schizophrenic in your sex life. You're bringing too many people to your bed, and when you finally wants to settle down, you can't settle down because you've got all these people in your bed and in your mind, in your experience. People lie and tell you that you have to have experience, but that's a horrible thing to have, because it would throw your marriage off. Number one, I'm going to learn. I'm going to move through this quickly. A masculine summons. The Bible says that he, that pronoun he, that means man. That also doesn't mean the pronouns that some of us are using, because some of us identify with he as opposed to being he. In this text is he. It's born male. It's he. It's a God pronoun. And I pray that Christians will use the pronouns God gave them, not the pronouns that they feel like. That's a whole nother thing. But the Bible says that he who finds a wife, you've got to get in that masculine energy, brothers. They say that brothers don't even pursue women nowadays, won't even speak to women nowadays. Some brothers think that women are irrelevant, or marriage is irrelevant. But God says today, and I want to challenge the men, he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from God. In the churches today, we all want to be blessed and highly favored. But if you want to be blessed and highly favored, brothers and sisters, as we're training you how to become the good thing that he finds, you've got to do things God's way. You've got to do things God's way. You've got to begin this masculine pursuit of the wife that can become a good thing to you. Now, you can't just go out there and marry just anybody. And I'm going to tell this story, and then the program's probably going to be over. The Bible says in Proverbs 2:18, the Lord said to him, it is not good for man to be alone. Listen to that, brothers. It's not good for man to be alone. I will make him a helpmate suitable for him. And this story that I share about is a story about a psychotherapist who decided to put together the perfect wife, the perfect wife. And he was 52 and 30 years older than the wife he sought to endow with perfection. And says that they ended up in court. And he, after she got the ring on her finger, things changed. The doctor stated that the perfect wife refused to wash dishes, that she wouldn't sweep, and the doctor took care of the baby, and the wife discharged, or the wife changed. And that's what the psychotherapist says. And then the wife said, he ain't all that anyway. He makes $200,000 a year and only gives me $5 a day to spend. So this story, a man trying to get in his masculine energy as he was trying to, a masculine search, he was trying to find a wife. Well, really, the man in the story was trying to make a wife. And this is what he say. And after all of that, he figured out that as he's a psychotherapist and he tried to psychoanalyze and create the perfect wife, the doctor explained that the reason that it didn't work is because he didn't psychoanalyze himself. Hello, somebody. He didn't psychoanalyze himself. And that's perfect, a perfect thing for us to look for, brothers. We got to take this search as introspection. And we got to prepare ourselves, both men and women, for marriage. We got to study this thing. I want you to get all of my books that I've written on relationships. You got to study this thing, man. Study for everything else. He who finds a wife, he's in a masculine summons, a masculine search. And this last point, a masculine stupendous. God says that when you find a wife, you find a good thing and you obtain favor from the Lord. Listen to this, brothers. If you want to be blessed. One book I used to have people read, it's The Millionaire Mind, because people want to get in the millionaire mind. The Bible talks more about money than anything else. And one thing I use that book to share about is that most millionaires were not millionaires before they got married. Hello, somebody. They found somebody. He obtained favor from God, and they found somebody that was good for him, and they came together collectively, and they became millionaires after they got married. You listen to some of these modern women. They want their mans to have six figures, a six-pack, and stand 6 feet, 14% in America, 6 feet, six-pack, 8% in America. And six figures is 1%. Hello, somebody. And as I told you, most millionaires are married. Hello, and they got married before. So if you want to be rich, if you want to be blessed from God, brothers, you got to get in your masculine energy. You got to begin the summons. You got to begin the search to get something that's stupendous from the Lord.
We don't need another.